Hi, I'm Steve Jones, and I'm going to look at calculating a weighted average. Now, a weighted average is not really different from an average. It's just a different way of looking at averages. And obviously, if I gave you a list of numbers like 6, 5, 4, 3, I could work out the average. So the average of these numbers is 6 plus 5 plus 4 plus 3, 5 is 11, 14, 18. And there are four numbers, so it's 18 divided by 4. Now, 18 divided by 4 is, of course, 4.5, right? So the average of those four numbers is 4.5. But what this doesn't say is what happens when you have, for example, not one of these numbers, but maybe more than one of the numbers. So let's say you've got a list of numbers of this kind. Now, obviously, I can't say 6 plus 5 plus 4 plus 3 and divide it by the overall number. The weighted average, although the numbers 6, 5, and 4, and 3 are the only numbers in the sequence, 6 is more important and 3 is more important in this case. So we have to make allowances. So the weighted average of these, which is the same as the average, is 18 plus 9, which is 27, 36 in this case, but divided by 3, 6, 8. And we've got, therefore, twice the number of numbers, but there are more 3s and more 6s and just one or each of 5 and 4. Okay, so 4 8s are 32. The weighted average in this case turns out to be also 4.5. Now, you might say, well, what's the difference? The big difference would be if instead of the number 3 being there, we had 6, 6, and 6, and then 5, and 4, and 3, without the extra 3s. We would then have 30, this time divided by 6, which gives us an average of 5. So the weighted average takes into account the number of objects, or how strong that value is represented in the set of numbers that you've got. So you have to take account of how many times it occurs.